Thank you so much, and thank you, Dainik Bhaskar Group, for having me here to talk about a book from Harish Bhat. Because again, in Zen Communication, when Tata Agni Chai was launched, I was a planner doing Excel sheet plan costings. So that was a different era, and we piloted it in Calcutta. And one of the biggest moments of discovery as a media planner for me then was life is beyond Excel sheets. I always thought it is about numbers and statistics. And when working with people, icons like Harish Bhat, you realize that even in a simple media plan, you can bring in curiosity and magic by talking about the consumers. And that's exactly what this book is all about. As Steve Jobs says, out of curiosity comes everything, you know. And what I learned from this book is this curiosity factor that I have without realization experience in my 2 decades of career. And when I read the book, I was like, "Arey, ye to kya hai? Ye to hua hai?" You know, that kind of moments happened for me. Mohit wrote to Harish Bhat and said, "You know, Priti is going to review the book, and no pressures, of course." This is what he said to us. He said that curiosity is the foundation of new learning, and if we are curious, then we can learn so much more in our lives. This, in turn, makes our lives that much more engaging and fulfilling. I also find that curious people are also very interesting people. And it's always a delight to speak to people who are curious and who reflect their curiosity in everything they see and do. Which means these are people who don't just sit and accept things as they are. They are wonderful questioners who will ask a lot of things all the time, not just for gaining information, but for gaining insights. So it's not about, acha, wahan kya ho raha hai? Bhai, kyun ho raha hai? It is that subtle difference in how you ask the question that makes you a curious person. And he's put in some good points in the beginning of the book. You don't have to wait till the end, where he actually has written that how can marketeers become curious? And it is all about, maine 20 saal marketing kar li, mujhe sab pata hai. No, be curious. Because what happened even 5 years back is not relevant today. And I sit in the crux of marketing where the demand supply happens. It's not the same today. Ask questions all the time. I mean, if you pick up any 6-year-old or 7-year-old, I have a 6-year-old too, amount of questions, after 5 questions, I don't answer. I go, because they have so many questions, they're just so curious. Listen extensively without judgment. And that's something, of course, comes with age. But if it doesn't come with age, then as a marketer, you have to listen. Because the more you listen to your teams, the more you listen to consumers, you come out with better product solutions. And observe customers with a keen eye and a fresh eye, which is why market visits become important, which is why going to places become important. And seek new experiences, meet new people. I think CBL has broadened my horizon from a media world person, just born and brought up in the advertising media industry, to a completely new set of people, like Mohit, on being met just like that on our conversations about Lucknow and books. And that's how we know each other. And that's allowed me to see so many new people. And embrace the unexpected, like 2 hours of traffic to Noida from Gurgaon, which I never thought will take so much time. But yeah, it's life is full of surprises. I mean, it's not going to be planned always. So be ready and experience it rather than worrying about it. And of course, the last and the most important is read, read, and read. The more you read, the better marketer you become. I'm going to touch about 6-7 things he said in the book. I won't talk a lot, but I'll touch one more thing. One of the things, one chapter is all about places you visit. And he's shared his experience about multiple places, the New York Apple Store, to the Oxford Street shopping in London, to why everybody should go and visit Kumbh Mela every time it happens, and how marketeers have tapped it. But what I liked the most was his insight about this butterfly bookstore in Mumbai. Because it's books, we have to talk about books. And where people are actually buying books by the kilo. And the pricing of the kg the weight is depending on what type of book you buy. So if you buy fiction book, the rate is very different. If you buy books on education, the rate is very different. And imagine what if things started getting, gold starts getting sold actually in kilo and not the pricing the which it is. And we change the paradigm. So this is one consumer insight he's talking about. Which are the industries that's going to slowly get into the kilo story and the weight story rather than other units of measurement? And imagine how we can unlock the power of consumer potential through this. And he says all these insights can only come if we go and see new places. I have studied in 6-7 cities, 8-10 colleges and schools, not out of choice because my father had a transferable job. But in hindsight, thank God for that. So I moved from Chennai. The worst experience for me was Chennai to Lucknow. I couldn't speak Hindi then. I knew to read and write. I still can't speak good Hindi. But imagine going to Lucknow and speaking in Lucknow Hindi. I mean, it's like what Mohit talks. I'm like, kya bole aap? Come again. So that to me allowed me to learn a new skill. You fight back. It allows you to change the way you look at consumer, people, the way you look at the culture. And it makes you a better marketeer. When I go and meet clients, I can today very confidently talk about how Chennai has changed or how Bangalore has changed or how Kerala, where my origins are from, has changed to say a Lucknow or a Banaras, because I'm seeing it as I'm traveling. And that is the greatest insight, not just looking at some research and saying the research report says so. Of course, that's a validation, but the real insights come from our own experiences. This is a very interesting concept. He writes about products. How do new product ideas come? And he writes about how we should have a license to be child again. In UK in 2018, the largest amount of books sold was coloring books for adults. And in India too, the largest book coloring book sold for adults was Sita coloring book. Did we know this? Why is this happening? Because of the stressful gadget life, people are detoxing. It's a new trend. How are marketers tapping into this? Is there a new product? This is a new product initiative going back in time. So crayon sales have gone up. Color pencil sales have gone up. This is one new emerging trend. Can we have that in our publications? I mean, just throwing an idea off the hook. People and books. It's like orchestration of music, right? When you see a music concert, everything comes together. Marketing is like that. The product, the creative, the color, the media, every element of marketing has to come together for it to make a orchestra. So this is another example where he shared of brands that have come together. And one of the important things he says is don't be afraid of failure, right? Don't worry about whether the first time around the orchestra is perfect or not. Practice. Marketeers is not about launch karke agar maine success nahi dikhaya na to main mar jaunga. No, practice, it's okay. Enjoy your failures to make it successful, because music is all about that. Festivals and events, he's saying why festivals and events are very important. He also talks about one chapter alone on what Indian women want. And if you know, Titan as a company has launched a lot of women exclusive products. And I have actually worked on the Titan Raga launch many years back. And one of the biggest insights that Suparna Mitra coined at that time was watches are so not so creative. These Swiss watches design was the only benchmark that we had in India. But what about women? And then they started saying women have needs on different accessories for different type of occasions, and we should have watch designs like that. And whether it's 1952 launch of Lakme, you know, which is for Indian skin tone. What is it that we have a solution for instead of L'Oreal and importing from other markets from that era? So these are few brands, and imagine one whole chapter on that. And what he writes in the end is that it is a difficult segmentation of women. It's very, very difficult. But if you crack it, then it's pots of gold. Other interesting and very lovely bit he talks about in this chapter is promotion, packaging and pricing, and how it's very important. And in within that, there's a subsection of how when you read this title, it says Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. You think, oh, it's about, you know, kids products and, you know, Nestle products. But he's actually talking about how kids are used as models to sell adults, to sell to adults. And it is, why do we do that? Because with kids in the ad, you empathize with them. You are able to say the safety, nurturing angle to the brand, and helps in breaking the clutter. So he's talking actually a lot of brands who've used this very smartly. I mean, in the old era, it's Murphy Radio, right? They had a baby photo. In global context, it was Evian. Evian had come out a whole series of baby commercials even till 3 years back, where the babies are guzzling the water and so on and so forth. So it is a very opportunistic market, and a lot of brands are still tapping into baby advertising. The recent that I can remember is the Flipkart ads. They're not babies, they're kids. And how they're behaving like adults. It just broke the whole Amazon money being spent in the market. Great communication, great initiative. The last part which I want to talk about is about consumer behavior and how it is the art of segmentation. You know, segmentation, I do a lot of segmentation exercise for marketeers, and it's all about, you know, there is a 5% nuance differentiation from one segment to another, and, you know, it's such a frivolous conversation. What he's actually talking about, real segments. How many marketeers are targeting elderly? Because today, today's elderly have much more purchasing power, say, than two decades back. They are independent, the kids have grown out, they are the third generation or the fourth generation in their life cycle, and they're well off. Large size men and women, of course, there are brands like All in Delhi, which I see, which is very aptly placed for big built women and men. And I love that because, you know, why should you not wear something beautiful and wonderful and designed for you, for your size? Or targeting the LGBT community, like Levi's has done. You know, so there are many such examples where he talks about cult of followers. How do we create that more smartly? And last point that I want to leave behind, this is a footnote in the end of the book. His daughter says that she's actually talked about how she's tortured at home. And she was like the Bakre ka bell, you know, pura sara experiments papa ne mere pe kiya. That's the net outcome of it. But what she says is curiosity is injurious to you. And those around you, acute curiosity can change your genetic makeup and affect future generations. It's a very powerful statement from a daughter. Thank you so much.